हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी विल सी अबाउट द माइक्रोस्पोरोजेनेसिस। व्हाट इज माइक्रोस्पोरोजेनेसिस? हियर माइक्रोस्पोर मीन्स पोलन ग्रेन एंड जेनेसिस मीन्स व्हाट? फॉर्मेशन। सो हाउ दैट पोलन ग्रेन आर फॉर्म फ्रॉम द स्पोरियाजेनियस टिश्यू, ओके, दैट इज कॉल्ड द माइक्रोस्पोरोजेनेसिस। सो व्हाट इज स्पोरियाजेनियस टिश्यू? हियर स्पोरियाजेनियस टिश्यू आर प्रेजेंट इन द एंथर। Look at here, it is the structure of TS of anther and it is made up of the anther wall, that is made up of epidermis, endothelium, middle layer, tapetum. These are the component of anther wall, okay. And here in the inner side there is a pollen chamber are produced. Here the four pollen chamber are present. That pollen chamber are also called pollen sacs. So these are four in number, 1, 2, 3, 4. Therefore it is called the tetrasporan G8 anther, okay. So in that pollen sacs it is made up of what? Sporogenous tissue. That sporogenous tissue are undergo mitosis division, okay, and they produce a pollen mother cell which is diploid in number. So that microsporogenesis are directly act as a pollen mother cell, okay. So now that pollen mother cell are undergo meiotic division. What is meiotic division and what is mitotic division? Yes, you know, in mitotic division what happened? The parent cell which is diploid in nature are undergo mitosis division and produce a two daughter cell which have also the same chromosome number as like their parent cell. Therefore it is called equationally division also. But what happened in meiosis? That parent cell are undergo first of all reduction division. Here there is a meiosis first. So here they undergo the meiotic division and produce a haploid number of daughter cell. So the chromosome number of parent cell and daughter cell are unequal. So here the daughter cell have half number of chromosome when we compare that their parent cell. Therefore it is called reductional division. Then that daughter cell again undergo mitotic division and produce a again two daughter cell which have again haploid in number. So in this way in meiosis what happened here? That is the meiosis second, which is equivalent to mitosis. So that produce a four daughter cell which have haploid in number. Therefore it is called reduction division. So this is mitosis and meiosis. Now let us see our main target, that is the how the pollen mother cell are produce a pollen grain. That process are called the microsporogenesis, okay. So here that pollen mother cell undergo meiotic division and they have two types here. First that is the successive type and second that is the simultaneous type. So let's see about the successive type. Here what happened? That pollen mother cell which have diploid in number, first of all they undergo meiosis first. What happened in meiosis first? Here there is a first of all the nuclear division, that is called karyokinesis, and after that, after nuclear division there is a distribution of cytoplasm, that is here the cytoplasm are distributed and they form the cell wall. So in this way one cell, that is parent cell, divided into two daughter cell, okay. So here it is the meiosis first, then after that they undergo meiosis second. What happened in meiosis second? The again that these cell contain the nucleus, they form the two nucleus. Again these cell also they form the two nucleus, that is karyokinesis are taking place. After karyokinesis there is a distribution of what? There is a distribution of cytoplasm and the formation of cell wall. So in this way there is a what happened? They produce a cell wall. Here also there is produce a cell wall and this one cell are divided into two cell. Again this one cell divided into two cell. In this way that two cell are produce a four cell, that is haploid in number, that is haploid in number, and these four cell are attached. Therefore they are called tetrad, okay. And that tetrad form of cell are called pollen grain. So in this way here karyokinesis and cytokinesis and formation of cell wall are in a what happened simultaneously taking place, therefore it is called successive type. Okay, then next that is the simultaneous type. What happened in simultaneous type? There is a pollen mother cell. First of all, they undergo nuclear division, means one nucleus are divided into two nucleus, but there is no division of cytoplasm. Therefore, they are present in the same cytoplasm and there is no formation of cell wall. Therefore, what happened? These two nucleus are present in the same cytoplasm and after that, they again undergo meiosis second. So here after meiosis second again they produce a four nucleus here, first, second, third and one nucleus are in the back side. Okay, so in this way four nucleus are present in that same cytoplasm and there is a no formation of cell wall and no division of cytoplasm, means in the same cytoplasm these four nucleus are present. Okay, and after that formation of that four nuclei there is a division of cytoplasm and formation of cell wall. Okay, so after formation of four nuclei there is a division of cytoplasm and formation of cell wall and therefore it is called simultaneous division. So in this way here also the four pollen grain which is haploid in nature are produced and they are also in the attached form. Okay, so this type of division are called simultaneous type. So in this way pollen mother cell are undergo two types of division, that is successive type and simultaneous type, which is very important for your paper. Okay, then that pollen grain are arranged in a different ways. So what are the different ways? Here first that is the tetrahedral. Tetrahedral means their shape is tetrahedral type. One pollen grain are present in the back side, so here therefore it is called the tetrahedral, means pollen grain are arranged in a tetrahedral shape, therefore it is called tetrahedral type. Then second that is the isobilateral. Here in isobilateral these pollen grain are equally distributed. Iso means here the same two pollen grain are present, here also another two pollen grain are present, therefore they are equally present, therefore it is called isobilateral. Then next that is the decusset. So what is decusset? These pollen grain are right angle to each other, therefore it is called decusset type. And T shape, so here the arrangement of pollen grain is look like a T shape, therefore it is called T shape type. And lastly here it is a linear type. So here one by one there is a arrangement of what? Pollen grain. Okay, so these are the arrangement of pollen grain. Thank you.